아니가.
Yeah. Hi everybody. We're here with Richard Armitage. So, thanks Richard for being here with us today. So, I know that many of your fans are going to be watching it now on Ferdinand Street Facebook page. And I can tell you they had so many questions for you. It was unbelievable.
Good. Let's go.
So, that's a great news. So, you're here because you play in Berlin Station, which is a show which is going to air on Ferdinand Street soon. Can you tell us a bit more about Daniel Miller, like the character that you play in the show?
Daniel is a CIA operative. He's sent into Berlin Station to investigate some leaks by a character called Thomas Shaw, who was loosely based on the whistleblower Edward Snowden. And he's like a probe. He's the eyes and ears of the audience to find out who's the culprit.
Then now, since your fans had so many questions, we're going to go to all the questions that they have for you.
Okay.
So, Martina wanted to know if you think that Berlin Station shows very realistically, you know, the life, what the job of a spy is.
I hope so. I think it's quite a murky, complicated, muddy version of the CIA because it's not set on American soil. It's how the CIA operate outside of their country. So. It's a tangled web, and I think it shows the flaws of each character, and it shows the pitfalls that they face. So, hopefully, we're giving a true portrayal of that life.
And would you like to be a spy yourself? And that's a question that also another of your fans. I think it's also Martina who had the same question for you. So would you want to be a spy yourself, or would you be too scared to do that?
I feel like being an actor is a little bit like being a spy, Martina.
Yeah.
Because you do have to take on different personas a lot, and you know you can lose yourself a lot, and you sort of every time you play a role you go undercover really with that character. And it was one of the things that came up a lot in Berlin Station is, you know, how good an actor is Daniel, and what does that mean? It's really about the information that he knows rather than doing a funny walk and a funny voice. So, but it's been an interesting experiment to find that.
Yeah, I never thought of it before, but yeah, that's true. It's kind of, you know, quite similar, like you go undercover when you play a role.
Yeah, completely.
So that's quite funny. So, no spoiler here, but you know, we haven't heard season one or season two on Ferdinand Street yet, so, but some of your fans wanted to know, like, if you had the opportunity to write the whole scenario for season three, what would you write about?
Oh, that's easy. It's something that I'm quite obsessed with at the moment. I think the title of the series would be called Follow the Money, there's actually a little clue at the beginning of season one. There's a USB stick in some of the first few moments of the show, and I would pick up that thread and tell that story in season three. I want to see where those billions and trillions of dollars that are in offshore bank accounts, where all that money's going.
Ah, okay, that's interesting.
Yeah.
So maybe we're going to see it. Maybe you can, you know, give the words.
I try and
to
feed
the
that
writers.
To the writers.
That's a nice idea. What has been your biggest challenge while you were filming for Berlin Station? And this is IJO63 who asked that question.
I think the biggest challenge from Berlin Station, probably in season one, was having a number of German scenes with German actors in front of a German crew and having to pass myself off as a fluent German speaker. I don't know if I succeeded because the German sort of disappears throughout the rest of the season, but it was a satisfying challenge.
Yeah, so you had to learn German for the role.
I tried.
Yes. That must be quite complicated. I wouldn't even try to do that, honestly.
Yeah.
Then another question, and I know that this one came up several times.
Okay.
What happened to Mr. Cat between season one and season two? People are very, very scared. You know, they're like, did he give the cat away? What did he do? Like, is someone taking care of him?
Well, I feel like Mr. Cat still lives in Daniel's apartment.
But where he is, like.
But we don't see Daniel's apartment very much in season two, because Daniel is undercover as another character. So, but I think Daniel's probably popping back occasionally to put food in the bowl for Mr. Cat.
But yeah, I can tell you.
But I think Mr. Cat sees a lot.
Yeah.
I think he might have a computer chip in his head. So Mr. Cat's the perfect spy. You could send him undercover and he'd see a lot.
It's like a drone, like
yeah,
a robot.
Yeah, could be.
Something like that. Okay, okay.
Drone.
I think your fans are going to be like thrilled to know that he's still alive, or at least
he's definitely still alive.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
Getting up to
that's
mischief.
That's great news. That's a great news. Something maybe a bit more detective or something like that. So in season two, you're playing the role of an undercover agent, like who goes into a far right party in Germany, and you had, you know, to make some changes for the role, like the haircut and everything. So people wanted to know, like, from an emotional perspective, how was it for you to play that kind of role, like neo-Nazi party or something like that? And if you had some, you know, quite strange, you know, outlooks when you were working on the street because, you know, of your hair and everything?
It was a really interesting, it's an interesting question, but it was something that I wanted the writers to kind of play around with, is to put Daniel into that situation, which, you know, we don't really know whether Daniel is far right, far left, where he sits politically. I know, but it hasn't necessarily been explored with the writing. We're assuming he's somewhere in the middle and possibly sitting somewhere to the left. So, but I wanted them to challenge his perspective of life and see whether he could be persuaded towards that way of thinking. And I was interested. I did a lot of reading and a lot of research, and part of my process was to try and understand and rationalize why people think the way that they do and what the outcome is. But yeah, there were some lines in the script that made me, that were like little electric shocks. They're quite hard to read and quite hard to speak, and especially when it's against your belief system.
Yeah, I can hardly understand it.
Yeah.
A few more questions now about your career, more generally, not about Berlin Station. So, Alison Rose, who is one of your biggest fans, I think, because she asked like, I think, 5 questions.
Okay.
She's been mentioning that over the past 2 years, so you've been acting so in movies, in on theaters, in animated films, in TV shows, and also been doing some podcasts and audiobooks. So is there anything left that you'd like to try as an actor or as an artist, you know? Any other things that you would like to, you know, to work in?
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to, I mean, I do have a kind of musical skill, which I've sort of left aside.
Musical skill?
Yeah.
Like singing?
Singing, or? And yeah.
So you can sing? Would you
want
to sing?
I think so. I think I can sing. I don't know whether it's something anyone would want to listen to, but what I would like to do is somehow put that on screen. I'd quite like to play in a musical film or to play a rock star. I mean, doesn't everybody have a sort of fantasy about playing a rock star?
Yeah, I think we all want to be rock stars.
So yeah, that would be something I'd be interested in.
Which brings me to very, very, thank you very much for this transition, you know, to music. So we had one of your fans who is GSF, who wanted to know, since in Berlin Station there are so many David Bowie's musics, if you are yourself a true fan of David Bowie.
I am a fan. I wouldn't say I was a true fan, but every time there's a Bowie track on, it makes you stop and listen. And it was one of the things that I loved about the show is catching those little glimpses of Bowie that would be playing on the radio in the background, or a song that would kind of just kind of bring you into the next scene. I think Bowie had such a presence in Berlin and such an association with that city. But and I love our title track. I was very excited with that song, but I think one of my favourite songs is probably Ashes to Ashes.
Ashes to Ashes.
Yeah.
Thank you for that answer. Will you be performing any play?
Any London? David Bowie songs? No, I won't.
You can sing. Can you sing a Bowie song?
No, I can't do that. But will I be performing any what?
So. Okay. Your fans also wanted to know, Mariana Kokos and Valentina Ancelotti, they wanted to know if you're going to be performing in a play in London this year again or not.
Yes.
Ah, do you have any more
I can't tell you what it is, but it's going...
No one's watching. Okay. No one's listening.
Well, it's sort of happening as we speak, but I'll be able to tell you in the next couple of days. And it will be before the summer.
Okay. So Mariana and Valentina, stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
You've been playing, you know, as an actor all throughout your career with so many great, you know, actors and, you know, movie directors. So anyone in particular that you haven't worked with and you would love to work with now?
Yeah, actually, somebody that I've been watching a lot on TV and some amazing things is Elizabeth Moss. I'm kind of fascinated with her. I think she's an extraordinary actress, and the opportunity to work with her would be a no-brainer, really.
So you would say yes, definitely.
I would say yes. And also Julie Delpy, who I'm still hoping that we get our film off the ground. So,
yeah, there's a project coming.
There is, yes. It's been delayed slightly, but we're still hoping that it will happen.
Okay, all right. So stay tuned as well for My Zoe. Is that right?
My Zoe, yeah.
My Zoe. Okay, so we know you for your role in Berlin Station, but we also know you for your role as Thorkin Oakenshield in The Hobbit. And people wanted to know, in particular, Brittany Larson, if you were to do some more fantasy movies or TV shows in the coming years or months, or
I would. I don't know what it would be. I feel like I would have to play something quite opposite to what I was playing in The Hobbit. So I don't know what that would be. But yeah, I love fantasy. It's a great genre, and I love working from literature as well. And especially somebody like Philip Pullman. I think his work is amazing. The Dark Materials trilogy. So. Maybe something along those lines.
If it listens to you, then maybe.
I hope so.
Since we're talking, you know, about fantasy and such things, you know, you may know that Amazon has greenlit a project for a TV show about the Tolkien universe.
Yes.
Would you be keen on working with Amazon, or, you know, working on a new project for Tolkien?
Yeah, absolutely. I think Amazon's doing some incredible work at the moment, and a new vision of Middle Earth would be fascinating, but I'm not sure where I would fit into that. I don't think I could necessarily play a dwarf again.
Was it fun to play a dwarf like this?
It was fun for about 10 minutes, and then putting the makeup on every day was quite hard work, and then trying to convince people for the rest of my life that I'm not a dwarf has been a challenge.
Come on, I can tell you people, he's not a dwarf.
I'm not a dwarf.
Thank you for this. Now, two more questions for you from your fans as well. So, Nicole wanted to know, so since you've been shooting Berlin Station in Berlin, quite naturally, and you're here today in Paris, what city do you prefer most? Be careful, many
I'd
French
have to
fans
be
watching.
So careful. Paris will always be Paris.
That's not an answer.
No, it's interesting. I traveled to Paris when I was working in Berlin. I had a couple of days here, and it's almost like Paris is the flirtatious sister of Berlin, who is the kind of very sort of serious, slightly older brother, maybe. So, but I enjoy having a drink with both of them.
Okay, that's a nice answer. And finally, what's your favorite French food?
I would have to say gratin.
Gratin?
Dauphinoise.
What?
Dauphinoise.
Oh, potato.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh
my That's God. Really good. That
Amazing.
Is really good.
I could eat platefuls of that.
Cool. Thank you. Anything else you would like to say to your fans?
Thank you so much. Have a good time, and thanks for tuning into Facebook Live.
Cool. Thank you very much, Richard.
Thank you.